So a lot of people will tell you we cannot combine logarithms when they have different bases. But the truth is, why don't we force them to have the same base and then combine them? Yes, we can actually do that, and let me show you how. The key is to use the change of base formula right here. So if I have log with some base b, and then let's say the input here is a, then we can write this as log of a over log of this little b. And notice that I'm just using the regular log on your calculator, right? And when we have log without any little number right here, it means that we have log with base 10. And the truth is, I put on this is so that we can use a calculator, but you can actually use a different base right here as long as it matches with this one right here. So you can do log base 2, log base 2, that's fine too. And another common log that we use is of course the natural logarithm. So we can also say ln a over ln b, and then ln right here, which stands for the natural log, this right here, means that we have log base e, and e is approximately 2.718 and all that. Okay, so let me come by here, and then here we go. So for the first one, let's just do it with ln, because once you get to pre-calc and calculus, ln is more common than the log log. So this right here is the same as ln x over ln 2. And then right here, we can just add, this is ln y over ln 3. Okay, now what though? Well, have a look. The ln 2 is just a number on the bottom, so we can look at it as 1 over ln 2. Times ln x. Likewise, we can do the same here. So we have a number in front of a logarithm. What can we do? Well, that's another log property, isn't it? If we have some number n times log of whatever base that you're talking about, and then the input is a, we can put this number back up here, and it becomes the exponent sign. This gives us log base b, and then a to the nth power, like so. So right here, we can just put this number to here, and then put this number to here, and make them into exponents. Then we have ln of x to the 1 over ln 2 power, and then we add, this right here is ln of y raised to the 1 over ln 3 power, like this. Now, ln, ln, and we have an addition of two ln's. So finally, of course, if we have log base b of a, add it with log base b of b. If this is a sum, then we multiply the insides. This is ln, same base b, and then we do a times b, just like this. If it's a subtraction, then we have a division inside. All right, so right here, we can just say this is equal to ln of, let's write it as x to the 1 over ln 2 power times y raised to the 1 over ln 3 power. So as you can see, we just combined this logarithm even though they didn't have the same base at first. Let's do another one. Now for this one, we have log of x minus ln of x. This time we have x inside and x inside. And since the second one is ln already, so why don't we change the first log, which is log with base 10, into a natural log, yeah? So this right here becomes ln of x over ln 10. And then continue with the minus ln x, like this. All right, and then we can do what we did earlier. Let's look at this as 1 over ln 10 times ln x minus ln x. Put the number up here to become a power. So ln of x to the 1 over ln 10 minus ln x. Now we have a minus. Well, as I mentioned earlier, if we have a minus, we are going to get a division inside. A over b. So this right here is just going to give us ln of x to the 1 over ln 10, and then over x, right? And x is like it's the same as x to the first power, like that. So finally, because this time the x and x are the same, so we can just do the rule of exponent, which is this minus that. So I will write ln of x to the 1 over ln 10, and then minus 1. So this is how we can combine log of x minus ln of x. That's it.